Now calling Deputy Gerry Adams.
Mahu, Cian Curtha, Gur Margaret. I was going to ask about Slovakia or Estonia, but I think I'll just stick to this state and try and get an answer. Taoiseach, you said on November the 4th that you would consider introducing legislation to compel the banks to pass on the ECB interest rate reduction to customers. Now, the avalanche of press statements from backbenchers, from Labour and from your own party, applauding this commitment show that they are very aware of the distress that mortgage holders are under. And while you have called upon the bank to do the right thing, the fact is the Bank of Ireland and Ulster Bank continue to defy the government, and the National Irish Bank has actually increased its rates, yet there's no sign of your promised legislation. Billions of taxpayers' money have been ploughed into the banks by yourselves. Bankers and bondholders have been bailed out. There's been no bailout for distressed mortgage holders. So, Taoiseach, can you tell me, can you tell the Dáil, can you tell the tens of thousands of people struggling with mortgage payments what you're going to do about this issue? Will you act in the interest of the people? Will you bring in or bring forward the legislation that you committed to? And if you're not going to, would you just say that, just be straight about it and say, no, you're not going to do that?
Unlike your own views over the years, when you were asked, do you condemn this or that, my answers are very straight. What I said here last week was that if the regulator sought extra powers from the government in respect of his position as regulator, that the government would engage and respond to him. The regulator has written to me and has said at this time he does not seek powers to regulate interest rates. So what are we going to do about it? The very fact of the matter is that the government called in the three banks for a serious discussion in advance of the question of the mortgage, of the interest rate reduction question, about their strategy for growth, about their strategy for lending, about the position regarding access to finance for small and medium enterprises, their capacity to meet the targets that they set out in the case of the two pillar banks of $3 billion a year, $3 billion this year each, and a number of other issues that were of interest both to the government and to them. And following that, we discussed the question of the interest rate reduction being passed on. I welcome the fact that Allied Irish Bank have passed on the reduction in interest rates. I'm very disappointed that the others haven't done so. And as has been pointed out by the Minister for Finance very clearly, the reason that the European Central Bank reduced interest rates was to stimulate economic activity, to provide an opportunity for further investment, to help people who are in difficulties, and not to have banks make a capital increase as a consequence of that. And that's ECB policy, and I would have expected that banks would follow ECB policy in that regard.
I don't think we can expect the banks to do anything, given their history and their involvement in the economic crisis that we're all trying to work our way out of. And I don't think also that the government needs the regulator to tell you what to do. You can see it in your constituency and every constituency across this state. You know, so you talk about being straight. Well, the government has appointed public interest directors. Just let me remind you of some of these. Former Labour Party leader Dick Spring. He gets a basic salary of €27,355.
Sorry, we're on supplementary questions.
In addition to a ministerial pension, this is a supplementary concordia.
Well, not, it's not really.
The former Fine Gael leader, former leader of your own party, he's the chair of the bank formerly known as Anglo-Irish, he gets a cool €150,000 on top of his ministerial pension. And in the Bank of Ireland, there's Mr Joe Welch, a former Fianna Fáil minister.
Time. We don't read from documents.
Tom Constantine, a former Secretary General of the Department of Finance. And they have earned €290,000 in fees between them since they took up those jobs. Now, Taoiseach, have you considered removing them and replacing them with directors who do operate in the public interest? Because what say to citizens have on these issues if the banks are just going to do whatever they want and regardless of the pleas and appeals of the government?
Well, the person that you mentioned, former leader of the Labour Party, Dick Spring, is a public interest director on AIB, and as you're aware, they passed on the interest rate reduction. The former leader of the Fine Gael party that you mentioned, Alan Jukes, is involved with Anglo Bank, which is no longer a bank. And I noticed that the former Minister for Agriculture, of long standing and esteemed man in his own right, Joe Walsh, a former member of the Fianna Fáil party, is a public interest director on the Bank of Ireland, which actually didn't pass on the interest rate reduction. Now, let me repeat again. It's not Joe's fault. No. You're up with him? Fact is, the government owned 15% of Bank of Ireland. But I tell you straight, Deputy Adams, I'm very disappointed that the Bank of Ireland have not passed on this interest rate reduction in accordance with ECB policy. The regulator, as you know, we have a regulator here, and the regulator's job is now looking at every bank to see that there is fair play across the field here, and I respect that from the regulator. He does say in his letter, the power to exercise close regulatory control over retail interest rates is not, however, being sought by the central bank at this time. But he does say, for your information, the central bank has two concerns. First, the standard variable rate contract has operated for decades, during which the reasonable assumption has been established that it would generally track the cost of funds to the bank. The exercise of the currently heightened market power by some banks in increasing rates for existing SVR borrowers would be an abuse contrary to public policy. Second, from the point of view of prudential and consumer regulation, it is possible that the deleterious effect on the mortgage arrears situation arising from large increases in the SVR could result in a net worsening of the bank's prospective profitability, but at the same time adding to the financial difficulty of hard-pressed homeowners. Now, you're aware, Deputy Adams, government have a number of measures in place already. The Keane report is being analysed. The House here is still debating. There are some measures in place already. The Keane report has brought forward 10. The House is debating that this week, this very week. And an implementation group of the Department of Finance is looking at other proposals that come here. I expect the Minister for Finance to be able to bring back a report on what is the best proposition to do here sometime before Christmas.
Now, I
heard you supporting the euro today.
Sorry, Deputy.
Well, deputies are entitled to speak about that bill. There are 15 speakers from this party yet to speak.
No, thank you very much. Deputy Butler. Could I put on the record that the Taoiseach or a minister is entitled to read in order to reply to a point put by somebody? Just for the record. Deputy Higgins.